Star Wars has been a household name for the past 30 years, a legacy cemented by three of the most imaginative science fiction films ever made. Sadly, three more films, purportedly sequels to the first trilogy, seem to have disgraced that legacy beyond repair. Even with the recent trilogy's utter failure to do the original trilogy justice, the incredible franchise seems like it should be the perfect setup for some equally incredible video games. But about 90% of all Star Wars games ever released were met with mediocre reception at best. While there were some shining stars in this void of mediocrity, like the Jedi Knight series of first-person shooter games and the highly successful Knights of the Old Republic, it's been a while since we've seen a really good action game bearing the Star Wars moniker. Star Wars The Force Unleashed was announced about as early as any other game on current generation consoles, and promised players some overpowering levels of Jedi-centric action. The concept certainly sounds promising, just like the setting, but it doesn't exactly live up to its full potential. I say potential in order to avoid saying hype, and while the two are often confused, there is a distinct difference. Hype is what someone expects a game to do. Potential is what a game is capable of doing. This is where The Force Unleashed feels a little cheap, and this feeling resounds throughout the entire game.
Where is your master?
The dark side has clouded your mind. You killed my master years ago.
Then now you will share his fate. A son.
Run!
In spite of this, the story is one of the game's more enjoyable facets, and while the taint of the new trilogy does rear its ugly head, the presence of elements from the original trilogy manage to counterbalance this, even though the game takes some easily noticeable liberties with the Star Wars continuity. The Force Unleashed puts the player in the role of Starkiller, a Sith warrior and a secret apprentice to Darth Vader. Vader hid Starkiller from Emperor Palpatine during the Jedi Purge, raising him with plans to overthrow and eventually assassinate Palpatine himself. Many pieces of the narrative are laughably campy in that cheesy Star Wars sort of way, but some of the twists and turns still manage to catch you off guard, and it's intriguing enough to keep you interested from start to finish. The really cool thing about the Secret Apprentice concept is that you need to literally kill everyone who sees you, which gives us a good excuse to obliterate everything in sight with, excuse the pun, overwhelming force. The gameplay is a combination of the hack and slash and beat 'em up action genres, somewhat similar to what we've seen in God of War and Devil May Cry, just not nearly executed as well. Like all Jedi or Sith, Starkiller has a lightsaber he can use to hack away at enemies, but the force powers available are obviously meant to take center stage here. You can use the force to blast enemies out of the way, fry them with lightning, or pick up and throw most anything you come across. You can chain these attacks together with your lightsaber to pull off some cool-looking combos on the more common grunt-like enemies, but the larger enemies get, the less effective your attacks become, and you're forced to repeat boring patterns or random button sequences in order to defeat them. This is especially true with the boss fights, in which the camera is often locked into a stadium view of the action. The boss fights also feel a little cheap because your force powers get nerfed considerably, and basically every boss is immune to all but one of your four attack patterns, you just need to find out which one. And of course, there's an oversaturation of interactive cutscenes, which no one in their right mind should consider to be actual gameplay.
What is thy bidding, my master?
The game's biggest flaw lies in what it could have done with some of its parts rather than what it actually does. Starkiller is supposed to be this evil Sith badass, but he comes off more as just a friendly kind of guy who isn't all that bad to begin with, which weakens the moral transition of the character throughout the story. The dark side-light side struggle is also disappointingly shallow. Rather than presenting the player with a constant stream of interesting moral choices, the ethical conflict is limited to a single choice you need to make at the very end of the game. While the combat bears some resemblance to Ninja Gaiden or Devil May Cry, it's not nearly as fluid. You can't smoothly transition from one enemy to another, and you'll often find yourself shadowboxing an open space or completely innocent walls instead of an enemy who's standing 2 feet away shooting at you, and the combat just doesn't feel nearly as refined as it should be. Levels are interesting enough, but environments can get a little repetitive. In spite of there being dozens of possible locations for each mission, the developers chose to have you backtrack to a planet you already visited instead of constantly pushing you forward into new and more interesting territory. No one flaw in the design ruins the experience outright. There are just so many of them, it's difficult to weigh them against the positive parts of the game and get a satisfying result.
Just trust me, okay?
Star Wars The Force Unleashed doesn't nearly live up to the hype that surrounded its release. No game lives up to the hype that surrounds its release. Hype is for stupid people who like to judge games before they ever get to play them. What we expect from a game is irrelevant in the grand scheme of things. What a game does and doesn't do is all that really matters in the end. What Star Wars The Force Unleashed doesn't do is offer a fluid combat system, rewarding gameplay, varied environments and enemies, epic boss battles, or a dark and mature experience. What the game does do is give us some fun force powers to play around with, cool-looking combos, cheap interactive cutscenes, a repetitive amount of idiotic enemies to mass murder, some interesting environments in which to mass murder them, and a charming story that bridges the gap between the atrocious Episode 3 and the classic Episode 4. There is some fun to be had while it lasts, and the sum of its parts creates a playable, but passable gameplay experience.